In today's video, we're going to be looking at the straightforward way to remembering the difference between epithelium tissue and endothelium tissue. So in a nutshell, epithelium tissue is tissue that interacts with the outside world, whereas endothelium tissue does not interact with the outside world. If we look here, we have our nasal cavity and our oral cavity through which we inspire air. Now that air will pass through the trachea, through the bronchi, through the bronchioles, and then it will reach the alveoli. Now if we look at the tissue that lines the trachea on the inner part, it is called ciliated epithelium. And if we can remember the function of the trachea, then it's going to be easy to understand, okay, epithelium deals with the outside world. Now the function of the ciliated epithelium is to secrete mucus right through the goblet cells, and then that mucus traps pathogens and allergens from the outside world, and then the cilia waft that mucus that has the pathogens within it away from the alveoli and up to the pharynx. Okay, so if we know what the function of the ciliated epithelium cells are, right, their function is to remove foreign material, then it's easy to understand, okay, epithelium tissue interacts with the outside world. If we also want to look at the alveoli, right, we can draw a direct line from the outside environment through the trachea, through the bronchi, through the bronchioles, and to the alveoli, right? So the alveoli have a direct pathway to the outside world, and that is why they have squamous epithelium as the tissue that makes them up. Now, before we move on to the endothelium cells, right, to the endothelium tissue, it's important to understand, in humans, our circulatory system is described as being double and closed. The double part refers to the fact that blood passes through the heart twice in each cycle. And the closed part, which is more important, right, for this topic, is that all of the blood is contained within blood vessels. There is no input from an outside environment, and nor do we don't lose blood, right? The blood is contained within all of the blood vessels. And so therefore, if we know that endothelium cells do not interact with the outside world, it makes sense that all of the blood vessels have the inner lining of endothelium tissue, right, of endothelium cells. Now, basement membranes, this is something that's important to understand. So all endothelium tissues, so all endothelial cells have a basement membrane, and most epithelial cells have a basement membrane also. So if a paper is asking us, through how many layers must a oxygen atom in the alveolar air diffuse through to reach the red blood cell in the capillary? Well, it's going to have to go through the inner layer of the squamous epithelial cell, through the basement membrane of that squamous epithelial cell, through the basement membrane of that endothelial cell of the capillary, then through that inner layer of the endothelial cell, and then through the cell surface membrane of the red blood cell. So we have five different layers. Now, it's important to understand, so epithelium refers to the tissue as a whole, whereas epithelial refers to a cell within that tissue, as an example. And likewise for endothelium. So endothelium, endothelial. Endothelial refers to the cell. Endothelium refers to the tissue as a whole. So that's it for this video. If you found it helpful, take a look at some of the other content that might interest you on my YouTube channel. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.